reason for my lack of personality, but I've been seeing around the internets lately that people have been doing mystery boxes where they go on eBay and they'll spend a certain amount of money for trash, just like me. So I decided to kind of do my own version of that, and this actually came from Shane Dawson, his video. It's a sponsored video. It's hilarious. It says $1,000 mystery box, but when you actually click it, you realize that he gave it to I don't know if it's Ryland, I don't know if that's his name or that's his boyfriend's name, but he gave it to him. It's just hilarious. You gotta go see it. Victor doesn't usually laugh at anything of his, but he laughed so hard at that video. But yeah, I am going to be opening a mystery box of triggers. Before I do that, we'll just go with the flow. So let's get started. Gotta get myself a drink. Part is these handles with my hair all over it. Gently squeezing out, but here's what it looks like. Little Paris, rustic, romantic-esque, if you will. Aesthetics. No, but okay. So just looking over the box again, it has the bronze rims and just little stamps and things like that for people. I don't know where anybody would take this, or I'd probably put it in the corner of my room to make it look like, again, I have personality when I don't. But I think it's really cute. This was actually given to us by my husband's sister. So, thanks. What the inside looks like, and it also looks like the box. This is the only time I'll be showing you the box itself inside, because it's all protected on the top. So let's put this over here. Maybe the first thing I'm going to show you, actually, will not be a body part, but I'm sure we'll get to it during the video itself, okay? Only time I'm showing you guys this box inside. It has the same pattern as the top. So this is it. This is inside. It's about how big it is. I don't know dimensions. I'm a high school dropout, so I didn't learn math. And I can't read because I can barely listen, so if you don't know where that's from, you should. There was a guy on YouTube who actually used to do videos, and I can't even remember his name because you guys know I'm terrible at that, but he did this thing called Thug Rats. If you guys know what I'm talking about, just comment down below. And Grandpa's like, I can't read because I can barely listen, like the voice, it's a voiceover, but let's get started. So, this box didn't cost any money. It's all just random items, some from my mother's house, some from my car, some from my house. My landlord actually came over today, so I have some things. Well, I have one thing from him, so. And there's stories behind it, so you get mini story times and just get to hear me babble. Like a, what is it? A cat giving birth, I think the comment was. I don't know. There was that shade. No, I'm kidding. All right. But I will give a trigger warning when I do find the little box, so. Tapping, crinkles, clearly this is a balloon, now if my science is correct, which we all know that it is not, there should still be some helium in this balloon. Please hang on one second while I adjust this microphone. Okay. Where did I bite it? Where did I bite? Right here. Shall we try? Okay, there's nothing happening. I don't think. Balloon right here was purchased for $5 at our annual Halloween parade, which you can, if you want to watch that vlog, because I don't show my children often, feel free to head on over to Karuna Satori Basic. So, this is the first mystery. Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Do you feel the triggers now, Mr. Krabs? Okay. Let's just put this over here on the floor. So, second mystery trigger. What could this be? To do with mold. So, the backstory behind this, while I peel the stickers, is I was getting brain fog for a long time, and of course I had to blame it on somebody. Let's play with the stickers. just dirt. I don't know. I put foundation on that hand. So, sticky stickers. Sticky, sticky stickers, stickers, stickers. Box of triggers. first thing let's open.
Trolls?
Genesis, Sega. But like I said now, and the GameCube was the best Super Mario Sunshine. This Odyssey game actually inspired me to buy it because of Super Mario Sunshine. I heard it was very relatable. Now all I need is a guy who's basically a nerd and doesn't really have any morals, and I'm going to, you know, wear the booty shorts and like lay with my legs up in the air crossed and pretending to be playing a game when in reality the cord's not connected, and lie and say it's a wireless cord even though the game system's so old that it doesn't take wireless cords, and he can take the selfie and then people will freak out, and then that's how I get famous. Just like Peter Mon always says, I'm YouTube famous now. Available on iTunes in 2034. But this controller is adorable. I got it for $28.99 at GameStop because this cute boy was actually there, and number two, it was, I think, pre-order or for pre-order the day of the release, so that's why it was so cheap. But then I realized you need to put the Switch on the television to use it. And one more thing, I'm really sorry if you guys can hear my mom snoring downstairs. It's so adorable, but it's like really... Okay, next trigger, and then we'll go into the extremity. Basically, I put it in there on purpose because I wanted to tell you guys something that you have been asking about for a while. What could it be? The Christmas pickle. Little backstory. Victor, who is now, you know, he's my ex, but anyway. I kind of call him my husband. It's like, you know how it goes. His sister, they have this memory. My husband had an extremely bad childhood, like bad. His sister basically raised them. He has another brother, but they had this thing during Christmas where, it was like a few years ago actually, where she brought home from Germany this thing called the Christmas pickle, and it's a tradition, I believe, in Germany. Please correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, where they do something with the pickle. It says, in old world Germany, I was right, the last decoration placed on the Christmas tree was always a pickle, carefully hidden deep in the boughs. And she did it because she learned it out there when she was in the military or whatever. And he kept that with him, like the memory. And then one year, she kept saying she didn't remember, but last year for Christmas, she got him this, the Christmas pickle. And I thought it was just so sweet, so. Because they don't really have a lot of family memories. But shall we open it? I'm sorry, my face is starting to itch because I'm on methamphetamines. No, I'm getting methadone. But you get it. Christmas pickle, which clearly isn't real. You know what this looks like? Oh my god, you guys, SpongeBob. What was his name? Earl or something? No. The jellyfish club, or what was it? Oh my god. And he's like, and SpongeBob's like, name for the life of me, you guys. You need to tell me. But here is the Christmas pickle in our mystery box of triggers. And that sound right there, that ding ding ding, is whenever SpongeBob jellyfish because of Mr. Krabs, and they make that song, and it's like, Brazilian agate. This is
is one of the hardest and most beautiful minerals on Earth. So wait, is it a crystal or is it not? The rough contour of the outside of the rock is a contrast to the beauty within. The finish has been hand ground and polished in Brazil. To get an idea how hard the rock is, try to scratch the surface with your car keys. It would do that. Diamond saw blades are used to cut the agate. It took about 80 million years to form, and every piece is an original. Some pieces have geode openings or sparkling crystal. Copyright black market crystals. What the hell is that? So whoever put this in my house, I guess thank you, because I really, I don't know. But this is very pretty. But I'm not taking my car keys to it. Like, I don't know what the hell that is.
But then one more time became 10, so let's go.
First, let's take these little guys off. reference, but you guys clearly know that that's not working. I'm so sorry about my mom snoring. You guys hear that? Listen, ready? Yeah, that's terrible. Oh, and a little disclaimer. This ring right here, I did a spoiled girlfriend roleplay, and you guys were like, oh my god, she's bragging about a diamond ring. It's like my grandmother passed away and left me this ring, which represents the five diamonds. Represent each of her children, one being my father. The whole family fought for this ring, but the little non-Christian, crazy psycho granddaughter got it because I was her favorite, so I don't believe in picking favorites, but the whole family was just always money hungry, and it was bad. Next trigger. Do with what we've got. Well, I'm all you've got. No good. Dealing them out, which obviously I can't do. Four. Count them. Four. Triggers left. Mystery triggers. I was like, it freaked me out. Okay. This little feather. I'm going to brush on the mic, okay? Okay, maybe I'll just told me any gun I
get some ticket rippings.
What is this? It says keep this coupon even though that it is a ticket, but okay. I don't know if that's a difference or whatever. Yes.
see them right here.
And it's basically from the skin stretching and going through trauma. But anyway, so he came in with her and she's like, I take my bra off and she goes, I got nothing. I got nothing for the rash. Like, she was like, what the hell? It was just really funny. But anyway, so after that, he took a look. I put on my bra and everything like that. And I know that's unprofessional, but it probably wasn't exactly what I'm saying. So he had this light and he got real close to my face and my eyes. And I swear to you, did you ever like have a connection with somebody? It's like their scent almost. It's like it envelops you and it's a beautiful thing. Like, but anyway, that's what happened. And I was like, I'm gonna die happy here. And you know, I wish I could find his name. Anyway,
next.
Put that here. That's not part of it.
We actually have 3 more triggers.
Sting it. So, actually, what's funny is I bought this like 6 months ago, yet I still have the tag for it. $1. Got itch in my nose again.
It's a penny, I think. Is it?
I don't know why I thought that would make a good sound, but anyway. That is it, my friends.
Internet friends.
Really graceful, what YouTuber calls, or subscribers or whatever.
Snowflakes,
but anyway, yeah, so I love you guys.